Today's lesson from the left comes from Jason Dion Bews. This is a photo of him here. You may recognise him if you've already seen the footage. This guy here, his lesson is, it's perfectly acceptable to hit a woman. Or hit something that's right in front of the woman's face so that that item hits her in turn. So violence against women is perfectly acceptable according to Jason Dion Bews. He runs a shop called Dion Handcrafted Acoustic Guitars. The site for that shop is closed at the moment. Wonder why, very odd. Contact Dion Guitars, whether it's a phone call or an email, let's start the conversation. What he doesn't put in the description here is that if he doesn't like the conversation and you happen to be female, he'll punch your fucking face. This article is from The Blaze, which pretty much covers everything about the events that happened. I'll leave a link to the article and I'll leave a link to the video from Rebel Media, which I will not show here because Rebel Media are notorious, whether you're on their side or not, for sending out copyright claims if you use any of the footage, which is very annoying because I wanted to show you this but I can't. But as I say, I'll leave a link, you can check it out yourself. That liberal male who got violent with female reporter at Women's March, he got charged with assault. I wouldn't normally make a big deal about it being female, because I think that men and women should be treated equally. But the reason it's relevant is because he was at a Women's March, and he's a male feminist. And feminists don't seem to have a problem with it. If only he was right-leaning, then it would be bad. But because he's a left-leaning feminist, it's perfectly acceptable. It's funny how that works. Police have charged a Canadian man with assault after he was caught on video at the Edmonton, Alberta Women's March punching a camera held by a female Conservative reporter who said the camera subsequently hit her in the face. And if you don't know that punching a camera in front of someone's face is then going to hit them in the face, then you're a moron. I always get them mixed up. Jason Dion Bews, 34, is charged with assault and uttering threats, CTV News reported on Tuesday. Sheila Gunn-Reid, Alberta Bureau Chief for Rebel Media, was covering the Saturday march and said she tried to interview Bews, who became indignant and soon violent. "Go away," Bews said to Reid, who was shooting video of Bews from her tripod-mounted camera. "Get out of my fucking face, I will break your fucking camera," said the peaceful, tolerant, feminist leftist who's, as we all know, they're just all about love and understanding and acceptance and peace. Police said Bews struck Reid's camera and the camera then hit Reid, CTV News reported. A few women there attempted to calm things and apparently blocked Reid as Bews walked off through the crowd and Reid was furious. She said, "Hey, don't tell me to calm down, that guy just hit me in the face." One woman told Reid, "You deserve to be angry, you deserve to be angry, but I'm trying to make sure nothing else happens." Which she would have done if it was a Republican that punched a woman in the face. She would also have done that as well. You know, it's nothing to do with being a male feminist hipster. No, not at all. Reid, in a later video report, said that the left-wing woman there helped him get away, adding that there was one woman there who said I was the problem. There was another man who said I provoked it all. There was another who said I incited it. One woman even blocked my camera with her sign so I couldn't film the little puke coward running away. "Yeah, I'm the problem, you victim blamer," Reid told those protecting the man in the raw video. Again, you can see this all in the video, I'm just not going to show it. Ezra Levant, founder of The Rebel. Ezra, see if you happen to watch this, could you please sort that copyright shit out? Nobody's taking your videos and passing them off as their own. They're using footage from your videos in fair use. Stop that crap. He told the Metro News, "There's something weird going on at a women's march when a man assaults a woman and the reaction of the assembled marchers is to assist him in scurrying away and to denounce the victim." CTV News reported earlier that Bews spoke with the network on Monday and said he'd talked to police and that he wouldn't face charges. CTV News added that Bews said he didn't hit Reid in the face, just her camera, and that he doesn't believe the camera hit Reid. Bews added to the network that apologised via a tweet and said he'd replace the camera, and that he and his wife left their home due to threats via texts, phone calls and emails. Because Bews, Jason Dion Bews, he's the real victim here. You know, he's the real victim, and all your sympathy should go to him. Two people who said they saw the incident disputed Reed's claim and said she was never hit. He just hit the camera off the tripod. He didn't actually assault her in any way, a self-proclaimed witness who called herself Tiana said in a Facebook video. Had she been hit, there would have been a reaction, said the other self-proclaimed witness who called himself Ezra. Yes, the funny thing is there was a reaction. She said, that cunt just hit me in the face or whatever. There was a fucking reaction. And, oh, he just hit the camera off the tripod. He didn't assault her. Which is exactly what this witness would have said if it was a Republican punching a woman or punching her camera so that the camera hit her. Bew's violent behaviour drew scorn from a couple of female Canadian columnists. Danielle Paradis wrote that his few short moments of ego threw the work of the Women's March into jeopardy. The fact is, the behaviour Bews displayed on the tape isn't okay, and you'd think a participant at a women's march would have the wherewithal to know why. When the cause is women's rights, that means you respect all women at the rally, whatever their reasons for attending, whatever their demeanour. If that's too difficult, maybe you don't belong there. The sad irony is that it's often violence against women that causes trouble at progressive events. In hundreds of Occupy camps, incidents of violence and sexual assault against women were well reported. Indeed, reports of men raping or groping women in the tents in New York's Zuccotti Park, I hope I said that right, was a part of the justification for shutting down the camps. Yes, as they say, if you scratch a male feminist, you will find an abuser of women in some way, shape or form, whether it's physical abuse like Jason Dion Bews, whether it's mental abuse like Onision, or whether it's rape like many of the others. Candice Malcolm wrote that modern feminism is no longer an inclusive movement to protect and improve the lives of all women. Oh, I'd say that it never was anyway. New feminism has morphed into an anti-Western, anti-conservative ideology. It aims to undermine men, especially straight white men, and fight against the patriarchy. That is, the traditional institutions of society like the family, marriage, religion, and even the economy. Malcolm added, some men, weak men like Dion Bews, use violence to intimidate and assert power over women. And new feminism bizarrely enables this behaviour. Ironically, even a rally for women's rights. Both at the rally and later online, many on the left have rushed to defend Bews. These leftist feminists have shown their true colours. They've demonstrated that feminism isn't about women, it's about politics, where a feminist man, even a violent one, comes ahead of a conservative woman. This is the regressive left, the real source of violence and intolerance in our society, which is really, at this point, undeniable. The Blaze's Mike Opelka interviewed Reid on the radio, and she said Bews is a better male who, on Tuesday, turned himself in out of complete and utter fear. Well, that's Jason Dion Bews there with the lesson, violence against women is acceptable. So acceptable that you can confidently do it while having many cameras on you at a women's match. That's how acceptable it is. But just a wee tip, just a little tip here, right? See if you're going to punch a woman in the face or punch something in front of her so that it hits her face. Just say you're a leftist. That's it. You'll get away with it then. Then all the women at the feminist march, it's a women's march. It's an anti-Trump march. But it's a women's march. They'll all be on your side. Just because you said, I'm a hipster faggot feminist, you know, therefore it's perfectly acceptable. I'm all about love and peace and understanding. Yes, Jason, go and fuck yourself. And if I was your wife, I'd be seriously thinking about getting out of that relationship, because you turn to violence in an instant as soon as you're upset, and that's not good for anyone involved. Thank you very much for listening. Until next time.